What's up, guys, and welcome back to another episode of Cork to Glory. This is episode number 6. And we start today's stuff as we look to close out December strong on the back of 3 straight victories in all competitions here against Stevenage at Turns Cross. Right now, sat in the bottom half of the table, feeling very confident after 3 wins in 3 and just 3 minutes into the game. And number 3 gets goal number 3 for the season. Yes, Barry Sharkey with another. And EA, as we found out in the last episode, don't tell me this guy has not got enough potential. He's more than good enough for this Cork team now and for the future. We know he can strike him. Third goal this season, Barry Sharkey. He might not show great potential officially, but he certainly does in our hearts. 1-0 Cork City, Sharkey was third of the season as the 18-year-old gives us the early lead. And 20 minutes later, a chance to make it 2-0. Nico finds Ewan Plantner. Top scorer so far, despite being one of the lowest rated players in the team, with a cracking finish after 2 little stop and turns there, makes it 2-0. And it's crazy, you know, he's got such a low finishing stat. It is gradually improving, but it doesn't seem to feel that way. Most of his shots hit the target, many are found the back of the net. One of the top scorers in the league, our top scorer, makes it 2-0, and in 3 minutes before the break, well, 3 of our youth players got the goals in this one. 3-0 was the final score. Ollie Nicholson with another goal. I believe already his 4th goal of the season, possibly 3rd, but 3-0 the final score, and all 3 goals getting scored by youth players. Barry, Ollie, and also Ewan as well. That was really awesome to see. So 3-0 the final score, and 4 straight wins in all competitions. Our best run of form so far in the campaign. But for our final game of December, taking on the Marinas, Grimsby Town away from home, aim to close out the calendar year strong with yet another win. I did make a load of changes for this game because on the weekend, this is a Thursday night game, and on the weekend we had West Bromwich Albion away at the Hawthorns in the FA Cup third round. At the end of the day, my mind was thinking about the trip to face Big Sam's boy, so I rotated a lot on my side there, lost the game by 2-0 as our winless run comes to an end. So 19 games to go as we close out the calendar year. Right now, Bradford are top of the table by 5 points. We're in second with 48. Quite a few points clear of the teams below third place, though, and the top 3 automatic promotion places, though. So with 19 games to go, obviously destiny firmly in our own hands. And if we can get back to winning ways ASAP, we've got some really favourable fixtures coming our way in January. The vast majority of not all of those teams are in the bottom half of the table, so we should be able to pick up possibly wins in every single game there. We've got a golden chance as we'll go into February of being possibly top of the table but cementing an automatic promotion place. But as Jan does roll around, you've seen that Fleming's deal has finally gone through, so he has been sold, and also an academy update here as well. You can see some of the youth players in our system at the moment. Josh McCoy looks pretty decent, 55 rated left midfielder. Again, Donoghue, the holding midfielder, I think it's Chris Donoghue, I think we called him Connor in the last episode, I think it's Chris Donoghue, looks really decent. The potential range is not dropping despite the low overall. And as for the money in our budget for the January window, £171,000. That is a decent amount of money, but to be honest, as you took a look at the youth scouts available there, what I think I'm going to do is just sit on the money, keep it in our savings account, and just let it carry over until next season. I really want another scout and getting 3 scouts here, but at the moment, the best we can get is another one-star scout, which, of course, as we know, in the case of Leo and Ollie, has picked up a couple of decent players. But I want a really class scout as soon as possible. So the more money we save, the quicker we'll reach that goal. So I think I'll keep the cash this January window and probably not look to make any moves whatsoever. So we'll look at our squad then as we do enter the January transfer window. I'm not against selling one of our players here with Cork and looking to continue bringing through the youth players and throwing them into the deep end. There are a couple of names I'm thinking about. 2 of the strikes here, O'Brien Whitmarsh and also Dinanga as well. Possibly Murphy too. Very low rated strikers. Not against cashing in on those guys. And also a couple of the centre backs as well. O'Brien, I quite like Slevin, but O'Brien wouldn't be against cashing in on him. One of the CMs, Holland, I think it is, wouldn't be against selling him too. Possibly Honahan, the young right back as well. So there are a few players I'm not against putting on the transfer list to raise a little bit of money. But again, we will barely get any pennies for them, so I'm not sure it's worth doing or not, really compromising squad depth for a very little financial game. But for the third game of today's episode, first one of January 2021, it was the big one, the biggest game of the series so far. West Brom away in the FA Cup third round at Hawthorns. When the tie was drawn, I wanted the Premier League side, I wanted them away from home. I had everyone fit and fresh after resting them all on Thursday night. I felt for sure we'd get battered in this game, but just 5 minutes in, EA, don't tell me this guy's not got great potential. Barry Sharkey, 5 minutes in, kissing the badge as well as League 2 Cork City. Stunned the Hawthorn silent and take an early shock lead in the FA Cup third round away against Big Sam's boys there. Great little ball through by Galvin. He loves to storm forward, Barry. 77 stamina and clearly he knows how to finish. 2 goals in 3 games and Barry gives us an absolutely shocking lead and makes it 1-0. However, the lead would not last too long. 18 minutes later, Kamil Grosicki fires Big Sam's lads back on level terms. Bit of an unfortunate goal there as well. Tried to clear it with Nico, but just didn't get the rubber to green there. Didn't react on time. I'll take the blame for it, of course, though, as West Brom find their equalising goal. And in the second half, clinging on for dear life for a replay back in Ireland at Turner's Cross here. 18 minutes to go. Well, this one was definitely my fault. A great save by Bossy initially. And as I tried to clear the ball away with Morrissey, trying to play it from the back as I do, surrender possession. That's such a dangerous way of playing away against a Premier League side when you're the worst team in FIFA. Come on, mate, just hoof the ball along. Try to play out from the back, gave the ball away, and Pereira in the end makes it 2-1 as the Baggies come from behind to claim the victory. So, I mean, they deserve to win as well. If you would have seen the stats, they took like 10 shots in the game. The majority were blocked, though. I put in a great defensive display, but in the end, they came through. The Premier League side flexing their muscles, make their way into the FA Cup fourth round, and our progress ends there. The board gave us that completely unrealistic objective of reaching around a 16. Look, that was never going to happen. All I wanted to do was get to the third round, phase the Premier League side away. That's exactly what we did. And we gave a good account of ourselves as well, only losing by a goal and taking the lead as well. Yeah, that was a decent experience for our first ever FA Cup run with Cork City. So following defeat, as you could see, we had 2 more scouting updates here from our scouts based in Republic and Northern Ireland as well. Put a couple more players in the academy, including the highest starting rated player we've picked up so far, Rory Keenan. A striker, 1.1 mil valuation, 17 years old, 6'1", and as you'll see as well, I do promote him straight away and give him a pro deal as well, but it's so frustrating. This is a common problem I'm having in FIFA with the youth academy right now. Oftentimes strikers, and it's pretty much always strikers as well, they have a ridiculously low finishing stat, and of course due to the development plans you can now set up with FIFA career mode now in the training, that is really handy because you can change their positions if you wish to do so, as Tobin also gets a pro deal along with McCoy and Keenan going into our first team here. That is handy, and give them development plans for their roles as well, like poacher or target man. But yeah, Rory Keenan unfortunately shows no potential whatsoever. Medium low work rates, 4-star for 85 strength and 93 aggression. Looking at his stats, he looks more like a defender than a striker. He doesn't look like a striker to me. Finishing, his stat is 46. That's one of the lowest technical stats he's got. So whilst he does have strikers listed positions, medium low work rates, I think, to be honest here, he shouldn't be a striker. He should be either a holding midfielder with the decent stamina he's got, and possibly a ball-winning midfielder. If you train that defensive work rate from low to high, that would be really handy, or possibly even a centre-back. So I'm not going to play him as a striker. He doesn't seem suited to that role. And of course, Ewan Plant is banging the goals left, right, and centre right now, despite the low overall. So I think really he should be phased back to play as a holding mid or a centre-back. Tobin is 6'6", so I've kept him at centre-back with the low-high work rate. 72 strength, 72 stamina, 78 jumping. Again, at 6'6", he'll be really good in the air. So I've given him a sweeper development plan. He and Leo, two really physical centre half, 6'5 and 6'6, they could be a great partnership. And Joshua McCoy was the third player I got out of the academy here. I'm going to train him as a central midfielder. He does have some decent technicals going forward, but he's got really low pace. And what I'd like to do is train the stamina up from 51, which is really low, and get him a defensive work rate as well. He's got great passing stats. He's very comfortable on the ball. Got a good long shot rating as well. I think really this guy could be a good box-to-box in our team if his stamina kicks on as it is right now. Pretty low. So yeah, 3 players coming out of the academy. And again, this is the one thing I'll give major props to for EA. I'm always very fair with them. Yes, there are a lot of problems with FIFA Career Mode, but the development plan this year, implementing that into FIFA Career Mode has been absolutely fantastic. I really, really love changing positions and player roles. It's just fantastic. So fair play to EA for that. So for our penultimate game of today's episode, on the back of the defeat away at the Hawthorns, back to matters in League 2, taking on the Vegans, the fellow Vegans, Forest Green Rovers here, beaten by a goal to nil. Ewan Plant, ironic, scores the only goal of the game as we beat them by a goal to nil with 15 minutes to go. And this is why I'm not fussed about changing Rory Keenan from striker to holding mid, because again, Plant right now is banging in the goals left, right and centre. We don't need a new striker, because even though his overall is low, he can't stop scoring. And for our final game of today's episode, fifth and final game today, taking on Rock Bottom Barrow here at Turner's Cross, aiming to make it back-to-back wins and try and get back on track here in the League 2 and try and pull away from the teams in the playoffs right now. Ollie Nicholson gives us the opening goal again, connecting with a Barry Sharkey cross. I'm loving some of the youth players in this team. And I'll say it every single episode, but I so badly hope at least one of them has shown great potential. But it's Ollie with a goal. It's 1-0 Cork City. And with 4 minutes going to first half, still leading by one, looking for a second. Nicholson and Plant play a couple of 1-2s. Ollie back into Morrissey. Great through ball by the captain, Morrissey. And what a finish by Rory Keenan as well for his first goal in professional football in just his second games. Yep, the youth players really turning up today. 2-0 the final score as we beat bottom-placed Barrow and get the big 3 points. And as you'll see by the league table here, 3 games to go in January. Right now in second place, 5 points behind the Bantams, who lead the way with 59 points. So we do have the game in hand, and we're a whopping 11 points clear of Crawley, Port Vale and Bolton Wanderers in the playoffs right now. If we keep our winning run going, we've got a great chance of cementing an automatic promotion place and keeping ourselves within title contention against the best team in the league so far, Bradford City. But that was this episode of Cork to Glory, guys. Big thank you. Fortunately, you've enjoyed it. And if you have enjoyed today's episode of the RTG, then please do drop a like. Much love to you all. Have a fantastic day. And I'll see you for the next episode as we close out the January transfer window, aiming to go top of the table with Cork City very soon.